go ahead and get this started, and the program, the Slam Show, will begin. You feel good there, Giovanni?
Yeah, I feel wonderful.
Ah, you love it. All right, hang tight, everyone.
You're on the Virtual Entertainment Programming Network, TVEPN.com. TVEPN Studios, The Slam Show. And now, your host, Slam.
What's up, everyone? Welcome to the special holiday edition of The Slam Show for February 16th, 2015. President's Day. Yeah, we are on President's Day.
When you said President's Day, I was just thinking of the one you posted earlier with Clinton and Lewinsky.
That was kind of cool, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, if you have a sense of humor, it's cool. If not,
I'm sure the White House staff from that period didn't find it funny. But yeah, Lewinsky. Whatever happened to her? I think she went like overseas or something. Monica Lewinsky. Do you remember that, guys?
That was before my time.
I know she.
Obviously,
she actually was in a bunch of Weight Watchers commercials.
That's right.
That's her.
I remember that.
Yeah.
And did she keep it up?
Did she keep what up?
Her weight.
Keep her weight low.
Off.
Yeah, off.
Yeah. I'm not sure. She just kind of went under the radar, and I can't say that it.
She got really
her.
Skinny.
From doing them BJs.
Oh, that's right. And there
just
was
kidding.
They just opened up a new BJs.
Have you been to the BJs over in?
Long story short, it won't be long. But Eric and I went over there, and it was a soft opening.
Yeah.
And then what was I gonna say? I told you my ADD was gonna kick in. So they gave us the wrong order, and then she spilled her drink on me. And I was gonna say, I want this meal for free. But it's free. It's a soft opening. So what do? You can't do anything.
Like,
you
shoot it's free. Out of luck.
And the BJ's, where is this at?
The one in Concord, right?
They give BJ's everywhere. But
wow, you lucked out there. Just a little bit.
A little bit.
All right. There you go. All right, welcome everyone for tuning in tonight. And as I always do, I like to have my co-hosting staff introduce themselves.
Joe Corzo for Joe Time Entertainment. Hello.
Cindy here.
I'm the lovely Lady Sage.
Giovanni Abanoha.
Yes. And I am the main man, Slammin' Sam, here conducting this incredible show that we call The Slam Show. All right. Sound effects. We got to have sound effects nice. And applause.
That's his favorite button.
I don't even bother clapping anymore. We have studio audience. Thank you, audience. Thank you.
All right. Where shall we begin? Oh, has anyone seen that movie, 50 Shades of Grey?
We discussed that last week if anyone was going to see it.
Yeah.
So.
No.
Yeah, me and my buddies, we was like, nah. We got a group of us.
That'd be kind of lame, have a group of dudes. Together.
That'd be interesting.
There's like 50 of us.
Right,
and you guys are all wearing gray.
Yeah,
yeah, there you
different
go.
Different colors, though.
That's too much. So no one has seen that movie.
I got actually two different shades of gray. Actually, so here I am.
Here you
He's
go.
Not lying. Even on his Jordans, he has some gray.
Yeah,
there.
I got like three shades of gray on me.
Yeah,
I'll wait till it's on Netflix.
Agreed.
I don't own a TV.
Are you serious?
I gave up TV 3 years ago.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I did that. I for told a while.
You
this
is. Well, you gave away your TV 3 years ago.
Both, I gave away my TV and giving up the watching of TV.
Really? What about? I die.
Don't do that, sweetheart. Not right now. Not
TV
on my
shows
watch.
Aren't worth it.
That's interesting. Worse. Yeah, I heard there was some negative reviews for 50 Shades of Grey, mainly, and everyone's saying just stick with the book if you want to find out all the little sexual erotic S&M sort of descriptives. Stick to the book because you're going to get a lot out of it rather than this little truncated movie that they put out. And I was thinking, wouldn't it be kind of awkward if you're with a bunch of your friends and you're seeing this freaking erotic scene and it's like, okay, this seems almost porn-like. I should be watching this alone at home rather than with a whole bunch of people.
I would rather watch porn with a whole bunch of people than watch that.
There you have it.
Okay.
So each their own, right? If you could think of it, somebody's into it.
Exactly. Yeah. That's the Captain Fantastic saying.
It's rated R. I mean, what can you get out of a rated R movie? I mean,
what does that even mean?
A little nipple slip here and there.
Yeah. Because rated R could vary. It could be a certain amount of nudity or a certain amount of blood.
Brief nudity.
Or a certain amount of profanity. It varies. But yeah, in this case.
Now, this show is what? Well,
I was going to look for that. Brief nudity.
It's a sliding scale.
On the Slam Show, you could say everything.
You just can't say. And then you can't say.
You can't say. No. You can't say everything.
Just not derogatory terms.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
But curse words that are in a contextual use for emphasis.
And it's not in a malice.
Contextual.
Contextual.
I have to Google that one.
Contextual.
So, guys, let's go ahead and kind of review our past weekend happenings, as we always do. So, Joe, take it away.
Yeah, it was actually pretty chill, you know. Just do a show, no big deal. Showtime Comedy Show at Hamachi. 85-plus people came out.
Nice.
A couple sponsors. And then, yeah, shout out to them, man. Lana's Egg Whites, Heinz Realty.
Lana.
10% of the proceeds are going to Heart of Hero Foundation. About to connect with Ricky Mena, possibly tomorrow, most likely. It's my next day off. So I'll actually be contributing $150. So that's going to be awesome. It was a great show. Did a few shows over the weekend. Worked every single day as well at the Cheesecake Factory because people love the Cheesecake Factory on Valentine's Day weekend. And Valentine's Day was even crazy. I mean, like 2-hour waits, 3-hour waits. People still waited. It's disgusting.
Really?
Yeah. And and then went out to watch Faze on Love this Sunday. That was pretty awesome. He's fucking hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
And I love comedy, man. Just watching that just inspired me to keep it going. And got like these two random couple came into my work and they were like, man, you look like this comic that we've seen before. And like, man, does anybody tell you look like this comic, man? I like, oh, and they're like, what's his name? Like, what's your name, man? I was like, Joe. Joe what? Joe Corzo. Man, that's you, man. You die, bro. I was like, yeah, okay. And they're like, man, you hilarious, man. You hilarious. My lady, man. Da-da-da. We were just talking about you as the guy, man. That's fucking funny. He's like, I'll take you pictures of me at my work.
That's dope.
I gave him tickets to my show. March 24th, Tommy T's, Pleasanton. Gave him free tickets to my show, and it was hella juice. And then, yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was so funny. And then, just did that and just prepared over the week. Been doing a lot of studying lately and just working and just trying to develop myself. And I learned so much over that show. Like, I want to build a team, so be on the lookout, man. I'm building a team, man. It's going to be crazy.
The Joe Time Team.
The Joe Time Team.
Go Joe.
It's going to be fun.
What kind of team? I mean, what industry?
Comics?
Not necessarily just comics, but like just for the whole building of producing shows. Like, I wore too many hats that night.
I see.
He will unveil that later on.
Needs a personal assistant, a hot one.
I just need one that's more detail-oriented than I am.
Just be thankful that you wore a hat.
Yeah, for sure. everything was great. It was a great weekend, man. I'm looking forward to this week and the weeks to come.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Is that Joe right there? Is that
That's
you?
Me.
Look at that, dude.
In the flesh.
Guapo.
Guapo.
I had to kick that in. Right on. Cindy, a.k.a. Captain Fantastic.
Yeah.
Can we get an applause?
Oh, I'm already getting applause. That's great.
I love that.
Hey, if Gio wants an applause, you're going to get applause.
Okay, right on. I'm fine with that. Let's see. I did call out for work. I was laid up with some consumption of death, fever, whatever. But I pulled it together for dinner on Valentine's Day. Jeremiah pulled out all the stops. We went to the Culinary Institute of America.
Ooh.
And they had like a full on like, you know, Valentine's wine pairing and dinner, caviar and foie gras and everything fancy that you could think of. And then Sunday, we went up to Reno to go see Real Big Fish and Less Than Jake at the Knitting Factory, which is super fun. They're great live. They still got it, you know, 20 years of touring and recording, and they're still awesome. And it's always cool to see people like that. And you're like, oh, you're not all decrepit and shitty now. That's awesome. I'm so glad. But, yeah, that's my 90s decade was very different from your guys's. Your guys's was, you know, like Tupac and Biggie, and mine was
New Kids on the Block.
Mine was ska bands and sneakers and very dorky
mine
things.
Mine was Glenn Miller, right?
Mine was like all that.
Yeah.
Candy Kale.
Oh, I love that.
Save My Bell.
Right?
Chumbawamba.
Boy Meets World.
That's cool. Right on, right on.
Full house.
Full house.
Sage, we're going to skip you because
Thank
we're going to...
Thank goodness, I didn't do anything special.
No,
I'm
but
just kidding.
We'll tie it in with the events that we did together because it's pretty, pretty epic. So we'll get into that. So
20 Shades of Grey.
20 and a half.
20
Giovanni, how are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good, good. How was your weekend?
This weekend was fantastic. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was great. it was wonderful. Thank you.
Performances? Anything exciting, or was it just more laid back?
It was laid back. I did have a Valentine's gig for a private group.
Cool.
My pianist and myself did for about 200 people.
Nice.
It was more intimate, and
that's intimate. That's a lot of people.
Yeah. Considered intimate when it's a private affair.
Got it.
I was trying to keep a straight face. Yeah, it was good.
Did you
good.
Rock the house?
As much as I could be. As I possibly could. So, yeah, it was really good. It was fun, and it was one of the first performances that Bob Athade and myself did together. He's a Bay Area guy, and pretty well known. So.
That's awesome. That's awesome. You got to be able to have these performances where you, it's intimate to you, mm-hmm. but to us, 200 people, that's a lot of people.
Yeah. It means.
Like the Joe Time event over at Hamachi, that was 80 something. That was pretty intimate.
Yeah, I'd say.
I would say it was still a lot of people. Intimate to me is like 15. Party of 15 right here.
Yeah, you know, agreed.
And it's the smaller groups that intimidate me the most.
Because
it's you can focus on them and it's just a little more. That's scary to me.
Gotcha.
How about you?
Yeah,
depends.
Small
the group, I mean, it's like.
But I've always learned, like, certain tricks. Like, you know, when I have a smaller group, any chuckle is good.
Yeah.
Like, if you're a chuckle, that's like a whole room being like, ah.
Right.
Yeah, so it's, you know. So if I hear just a chuckle, I'm like, yes. I got some fire.
Exactly. Or you just pump the speakers with this.
Yeah, right.
Or wait, that's the wrong one. You got to pump it with this.
Creepy laugh.
I want to know how much she weighs.
But see, it's different for you because you're singing.
Yeah,
you
feel like
don't
it's
want
so
people
yeah.
Laughing.
So singing to like 3 or 4 people is different.
I sent someone home because they were talking. No, I'm just kidding. That's like what Sinatra would do.
But yeah,
I don't
yeah.
Do
really, you would do that?
Oh,
oh, I'm sorry. I don't know why.
I've heard stories, but you know, that was a different time then.
Yeah.
I don't think it can be done today. So.
I think you can still kick out people.
Like stop a whole show and then just send them away.
You whore. That sort of thing. So.
Do you want to get up here? You know.
Right. Get these tramps out of here.
Tramps. It's not ratchets, it's tramps.
Yeah.
That's right.
Exactly. Oh, my goodness. Right on. Well, it sounds pretty exciting. We'll break it down on more of the Giovanni Abanoja endeavors in your exclusive interview
yes.
segment later on in the yes. program. So, Sage!
What up?
We did a little event over in Fairfield on Saturday.
Well, let's back up. Aren't you going to ask me what I did for Valentine's?
Yeah, that wasn't at Valentine's. So
Saturday was Valentine's,
yeah. That was it, right?
Yeah.
Saturday? Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm lost.
Well, I should back up a little bit and just add on to the Joe Time event over at Hamachi's.
That's Friday. Okay, let's say Friday.
Exactly.
There
let's
you
work
go.
It that way. That is more chronologically set up. So on Friday, yeah. I did the event with Joe Time. I provided all the music for the after party, and that was great. Much props to Joe for putting together a great event. And I'm looking forward to another one later on this year.
Yeah.
Going to do it more tighter and better and bigger, and I'm proud of you, bro, being able to put that together.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate
and you were getting down at the end there, just getting your shimmy on, your Glenn Miller grooves going.
Yeah, you know.
To some little Chris Brown.
Jitterbug.
Was he doing his double step cha-cha there?
Was that no?
No, none of that.
They didn't want to break that out.
And I was even throwing the 70s thing. Dun, 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 dun.
Do it again. Yeah.
Do it again. Do it again.
No, I was doing the do do do.
I like that. I'm still in that.
So yeah, let's go ahead and roll with the Saturday event.
Oh my God, Saturday! I actually had to work. Well, actually, the highlight of my day was getting my nails done, and I'm happy about
nails.
That. Yeah, I got some bling and. Love it. Gotta go with the tone of the holiday, you know, red nails, getting ready for work. So, and a certain individual drove me because I was just not having to drive. So, thank you, Slam, for driving me. That's a treat, you know, when someone takes you to the nail salon and waits for you and then drives you everywhere. It's fantastic.
Kind of is.
Right? You don't have to mess up your nails.
At least it's only once a year.
Take notes, people.
So that's Friday. And then that evening, I had to work. I did a Grey Goose promo out in Fairfield. It's a restaurant lounge, just like Hamachi's. It's called Mandarin Restaurant. And, yeah, I actually worked, and I had a bodyguard with me because he wasn't working that evening. And I got him totally wasted. He was supposed to be my DD. I became the DD.
Double D.
As you can tell,
designated
I am being quiet
driver, yes.
About double all this.
Good Lord, this guy was out of control.
It was semi-deja vu, but not too much. Yeah.
So I'm glad you had a good time. It was it's a breath of fresh air when it's the other way around. Usually, like when he's DJing, I'm hanging out with him, and you know this time he was hanging out with me. But yeah, free liquor.
There you go. There you go. Giovanni, what was it? What's going on?
This seat keeps swiveling on me.
Are you serious? You want to switch?
It?
Oh, you're gonna have to wait till the break.
Okay.
No, you're just messing with me, man.
No, I'm serious.
It's bothering you? It's like...
Oh, I have to keep rearranging myself.
Really?
It's moving on its own.
It's called keep your ass still.
No, it keeps moving this way. I'm trying to look at you guys, and then it keeps going this way. I'm like struggling over here. I'll wait.
It's okay.
That was our first guest complaint on the scene, ladies and gentlemen.
That's an OSHA issue. My neck is straining.
Oh, my goodness. And the following day, we actually missed the East Bay Comic Con event that was held over at the Hilton in Concord. And that was something we really wanted to go to. But unfortunately,
Stallion was there, right?
Yeah. He was dressed as
Jason for Jason. Friday the 13th.
Yep. Yeah, he spends a lot of money on that outfit.
It looked like it was legit.
Very legit. Because most of the time, people, when they put that mask on, it's just their face. He has another layer beneath that. So when you lift it, it shows the grotesque mutilation that the actual Jason went through in the movie.
Wow.
So, yeah. And he has a bunch of these masks. I don't know, at least 20 of them from each different movie creation. And he's like, he tells me, oh, this is, can you tell the difference between this one and this one? I'm like, no, they look like freaking hockey masks to me. And he goes, there's one crack here that's not on here because it's from the movie where he got hit with a certain axe. And I'm like, okay.
He's a Jason fan, huh?
Big time.
That's funny. He's like the opposite of Harvey Hero. He should like do that. like visit like kids that are like horror fans.
That's a good idea. That's a very good idea.
Or, no, visit the bad kids.
Yeah, visit the bad kids.
So, Stallion, if you're watching this, start your foundation.
Exactly.
It would be, what would the title be? It can't be, obviously.
Like a
harder.
Scared straight kind of.
That's funny.
Yeah. So, we ended up going to my cousin's event, Noah Coughlin, for his Run for Rare departure party, and it was an incredible event. There was a lot of people from the administration over at Vacaville in attendance, and he ended up receiving the prize, or...
It's not a prize. He actually has his own holiday. It's called Noah Coughlin Day.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's going to be...
He was anointed.
Yeah, he's going to be celebrating it every year, of course, but only in Vacaville. I kind of thought it was nationwide, but I'm like, hoo-hoo, two holidays off in a row. But it's just, you know, it's just in Vacaville.
That's right.
You got to go work in Vacaville.
Huh?
You got to go work in Vacaville.
Necessarily.
Well, I don't think it's that easy. Well. He was born and raised and all that. But I have a little slideshow of some of the highlights from that event. And, yeah, there he is on stage speaking to the crowd, talking about his past two runs and what he's looking forward to. This one, which he'll be departing February 28th from New York, to be exact, the Statue of Liberty, and all the way to July 4th, ending in San Diego.
Nice.
So if anyone deserves some applause, that would be Noah Coughlin.
Woo!
I'm looking forward to his movie.
And that's I actually right. have, I see I'm wearing a ribbon already from yesterday, and I have one for everyone. He is actually sponsored by this company, Global Jeans.
Mm-hmm.
And here's one for
you.
And if you could pass it
down. Yeah.
Can I put it on?
Thank you.
Absolutely. But okay, so, yeah. I have a. You know what I didn't ask yesterday now that you just mentioned it? You said he'll be departing from Statue of Liberty. Now, it's an island.
Yeah, it'll be on the mainland.
Okay. was he going to run over water?
Yeah, I think someone cracked a joke from the crowd when he said that. But yeah, he'll be starting February 28th, and if you want to follow his run, donate, or get more information on his efforts, go to run4rare.org, and be able to get in detail a lot of what Noah Coughlin is doing on this run. This is freaking amazing.
This is going to be... His third run.
His third run.
And he's going to definitely absolutely complete it on July 4th, and he'll be the first American to do it.
Ever.
Ever.
Yeah.
Running three times across the country.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So this
amazing.
Is. Amazing. Yeah, it is really amazing. And he's going to do it with a support staff, which will follow his progression from beginning to end. And
I don't know how to do this.
Oh my God.
You're going to have to figure it out, Joe.
Inside.
But yeah, think about this, Gio. He has to run basically a marathon a day to sustain the ending time that he's aiming for July 4th. That's
sometimes longer.
Yeah. Yeah. Especially if he's injured or he's taking a day off, he has to make that up. So I am just truly, truly amazed and very proud to say that this gentleman is my cousin, and I can't wait to see him back in San Diego, July 4th. It's going to be awesome.
We should be there to greet him.
Absolutely.
Field trip.
That'd be awesome.
Support.
Exactly.
There we go.
Exactly. All right. Moving on. Let's go ahead and talk about last week's guest, which is DJ Amy Robbins. And what a splendid, splendid soul. She comes in, and we very rarely talk about music. It's only about miscellaneous stuff. And she comes in as a DJ. And getting down to the nitty-gritty with the whole cheerleading aspect was kind of cool. And for her to say, yeah, I might be able to do it if certain teams give me a call. It's like, all right, well, not necessarily Niners, but if the Golden State Warriors come calling, she might be open to it. So let's get everyone's opinion from last week's show, Joe Time.
What
you got that ribbon on nice?
It's on.
Yeah.
It's there.
There you go.
There you go.
But, no. She's awesome. I mean, I had a great time on the show with her. Just love her charisma and her energy. It really, I was really exhausted that day, and she brought the energy up in the room. So I was able to transmute that energy and allow myself to have an amazing time, as I always do. But it just feels like she was just, like, so interactive with the whole experience and being there. It was just like, yeah, everybody was cracking up, and it was a trip. It was really funny. Her being a cheerleader for the Gold Rush girls, always a fucking plus. Fucking mm-hmm. love the Niners. And she's just an overall awesome person, and looking forward to listening to her next EP that she's putting together.
That's
and,
right.
I think it's out in March or May or March.
I think she said March, right?
March.
Something like that.
Yeah. She has to mix it down and master it and all.
Yeah. So hope you had a great trip in Washington, D.C.
She's actually still there. I just saw her post. Her flight got delayed. So she's like, anyone in D.C. want to party? I'm here.
That's networking.
Hell yeah.
So she's still there.
Yeah. Safe travels, man. Stay warm.
Yes.
Right on. Cindy.
Yeah. Like he said, I can't wait to hear her record when it comes out. Just by the groups that she said she likes and all the groups that she's liked as a dancer and as a DJ, it's going to be pretty cool to see what she comes up with, given all those influences. And, you know, every time we have a repeat or a follow-up kind of a guest, it's really cool to see how far they've come.
Mm-hmm.
And I think she's pretty much done most of the stuff she set out to do in the last time she's visited. So by the time next time she's here, you know, all those projects, we'll get to see how they came out. I'm pretty confident she'll get those things done because she's awesome.
Absolutely. Sage.
I shouldn't say I have a favorite guest that would be, you know, that was here on the previous show, because that wouldn't be fair, but she is actually one of my favorites. I mean, it's
off
just
the record.
On the record.
I hope to be the second most.
Okay. Okay. No problem.
On
no,
the
you
record.
You gotta be you have to impress me. So she's definitely one of my favorites. She's very interactive. It didn't even feel like we were on a show. It felt like we were just all hanging out, conversating. And I definitely want to go out and, you know, see her in person and support and see her drunk. See her drunk off her mind and DJing at the same time. So, yeah, definitely looking forward to that.
Yeah. And, Jill, you said that you admired her beautiful eyes earlier.
Her when mata. Lucky ng yung mata niya eh. She had a beautiful set. Excuse me. She had a beautiful pair of eyes.
There you go. There you go.
Laughing eyes.
And if you guys missed that episode, be sure to go to our website at theslamshow.com or theslamshow.tv to watch that replay as well as other archived episodes. Oh, and I'll be DJing for the first time this Saturday over at Farrington's Bar in Pleasant Hill. Mm. So if you're not doing anything, come by and support. It's going to be a good time since I am moving residences from certain areas. That will be my new spot.
Nice.
So check it out. Farrington's Bar in Pleasant Hill.
Next to Nations.
That's right.
It's actually, it has pool tables, darts. So it's not just like, you know, you're stuck there dancing and drinking. There's a lot of things to do. So I'm actually going to come out and support and see what's up.
There you go.
There you go.
You're going to come out, Gio?
Absolutely.
Right on.
Freaking-lutely.
Right on, right on. Okay, we're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break and be back with our topic segment and get the show rolling on that end.
After these messages, you
wanna
ride back.
You want to sing it?
Do you know that?
That's the
from
frog.
Saturday morning. No,
absolutely, yeah.
I got
yeah.
you.
That was awesome.
You can't wait. You can't wait. All right, everyone. Hang tight. We'll be in a few seconds. We'll cut it short because I want, you know what, actually, bring us into the commercial break. Go ahead.
Right now?
Yeah, go ahead.
What am I doing?
A little singing intro slide.
Not the main one, just the small something.
Yeah, just a small something. Go ahead. No, because you started it. I was like, hey.
Oh, I don't know. I thought we were going to go into a commercial.
Ah!
Let's go into commercial.
All right, we'll go into commercial. We'll be right back.
If you're suffering from chronic pain, migraine headaches, or any other health issues, it might be your back telling you it's time for an adjustment. Come check out the new Health Chiropractic Center in Concord. We restore the curvatures of the spine to bring you back to good health and wellness. Our specialists will provide a full examination and x-rays for free. Just mention the Slam Show. Call now for an appointment at 925-759-9722 or online at thenewhealthcc.com. In order to transform your health, you have to try something new. The New Health Chiropractic Center.
weekends you want to spend with family, friends, doing stuff that you love. You don't want to spend weekends looking for a new car, burning through weekend after weekend on the hunt. Instead, you got to check TrueCar and the TrueCar mobile app. In 5 minutes, TrueCar's app not only lets you build the car that you want, it tells you what others paid for it and lets you lock in guaranteed savings, usually over $3,000 less than MSRP. So get your weekends back at the car you want without stressing over overpaying. Save time, save money, and never overpay. Download the TrueCar app today.
What are you doing?
I'm turning this hedge into a dolphin-shaped topiary.
But this house isn't yours. In fact, I just showed it to you.
Oh, I'm gonna buy it.
Softly confident.
Well, I am an excellent candidate for a home loan. I pulled an 809 FICO score at Experian.com, so getting a mortgage is merely a formality. What do you think I should do with this other hedge? A giraffe?
Get your credit swagger on. Become a member of Experian Credit Tracker and find out your FICO score powered by Experian. FICO scores are used in 90% of credit decisions.
I'm a mid-century architectural wonder. A house made entirely of glass. So you can imagine my fright when giant pieces of hail started falling from the sky. Did I mention I'm made entirely of glass? Everyone was running here, running there, trying to get out of the house. But what am I to do? I am the house.
Your house can't protect itself. That's why the Geico Insurance Agency helps make it easy to switch and save on homeowners insurance. You could save even more when you combine your homeowners with an existing auto insurance policy. Call Geico, go to geico.com, or visit your local office.
Are you living with pain? So was Lisa, a brave Marine wounded in Iraq.
After surviving an explosion, I was on horrible painkillers. I tried 1 hour pain relief, and now I'm pain-free all day without dangerous side effects. And it works in less than 1 hour.
Try it free for 1 week and pay only the shipping with no automatic shipments. Call 800-500-1810 right now or visit onehourpainrelief.com. That's 800-500-1810. 800-500-1810.
Who did you let down today? If you're drinking too much or doing too many drugs, you probably let a whole bunch of people down. And I bet you're not sleeping very well either. Well, we can help you at the Detox Hotline. Let us be your recovery concierge. And don't think this is just another treatment ad. I promise you, we are different. We'll put you in a luxury-like getaway where our painless detox process will fix your addiction problem. And in no time at all, you'll get your life and your sleep back. Painless Detox is here, and our Recovery Concierge service will work with your insurance company to maximize your coverage. We are different. Let us help you break your addiction to drugs and alcohol before it's too late. Take 5 minutes of your time and call right now. I promise it will change your life. 800-885-2600. 800-885-2600.
Geico Motorcycle presents Reflections from the Road.
Let me tell you, the road is a much more relaxing place since I switched to Geico Motorcycle Insurance and started saving money. With that taken care of, now I can think about deep, important things. Like how come it's a pair of pants when there's only one of them? A real brain teaser. But hey, at least saving money with Geico Motorcycle is as easy as pie. What does that mean, anyway?
Geico Motorcycle Insurance. See how much you could save.
Do you need working capital for your business? Don't wait months for the bank approval. Get the cash you need today at businessloanstoday.com. Even if you've been turned down from a local bank, at businessloanstoday.com, we provide alternative financing to retailers, restaurants, hotels, contractors, auto mechanics, and hundreds of other businesses. Unlike banks, our unique financing services are flexible, with repayment plans tailored to meet your needs. There's no collateral required, and loans are not based on your personal credit score. The only requirement is that you've been in business at least 1 year and have sales of over $20,000 per month. Getting the cash your business needs is easy. Just fill out our simple application and we'll customize your financing to fit your needs. Then, within 24 hours after approval, your funds are available up to $250,000. Thousands of business owners are turning to alternative financing instead of standard banks. The application only takes a few minutes, so call Business Loans today at 800-669-9801 and see what you qualify for. That's 800-669-9801. 800-669-9801.
Yeah, welcome back to the Slam Show. This is a topic segment sponsored by Little J's. And Mr. Time, you went and did the pickup for us. Thank you very much for stepping up. Usually it's Captain Fantastic, but she was caught in traffic.
It was Skipper Fantastic this time.
Thank you, Aaron of Little J's. You know, it's the best sandwich in town here in Pittsburgh.
Tri-tip.
But Cajun chicken, and I actually had the
steak
veggie.
Steak fries, too.
Oh, yeah. Yummy. Thank you very much, Aaron.
I've known him for a very, very long time.
You guys graduate? Same time?
No, I'm much younger than he is. But much younger. Played baseball with a brother of mine.
Oh, nice.
There you go. Yeah, so thank you once again, Aaron from Little J's. And you guys want the best tri-tip? That is it right there here in Pittsburgh. P-Town. P-World. Exactly. All right. Let's go ahead and move on to our first topic. And I wanted to talk about this because it kind of connects with our special guest because he's more of a vintage type of individual with the singing style. And I actually did some research on it because it is kind of interesting when you think about how film colorization is starting to take its place in mainstream media, meaning that certain movies are being converted from black and white to color. And the video clip I have right now is from Wizard of Oz, which actually is a combination of two. When Dorothy goes from the Kansas part and walks into that, what's it called? The
Oz.
Oz. Yeah, the Oz area. And it is.
I was like, I hope he's not talking about Oz.
So Oz becomes color.
Technicolor.
And that was a style that obviously broke through a lot of sort of movie rules because usually it is just either black and white or color. But at the time, they just wanted to be experimental, and it worked out well. So that is an exception to the points that I'm going to make because you have movies like Schindler's List, Psycho. These movies are just... Exactly. They are in black and white, but to some degree should be in color because that engages everyone that are pretty much used to looking at everything in color. Because, like, for example, a lot of today's generation, they could care less about black and white. They see something black and white, it's like they tune that shit out. It's like, it's...
It depends.
Yeah, it depends. Especially if it happens to be something from well
back
worth.
Then.
So what I'm getting at is that when you're doing your viewing, we're going to get everyone's opinion on this. Do you feel if a movie is in black and white versus color, does that take anything away from your point of interest in watching it? So... My personal opinion, watching Schindler's List, I saw the movie, great movie. It was made to be in black and white, but I think it should have been in color. That's my personal opinion because we're viewing everything in color right now. Some people, believe it or not, when they see a black and white film, documentary, it's like, oh, shit, back in the day, that was looking pretty bad. Well, back in the day,
Did
everything
that voice
was in
again?
Color.
Do that voice again? I like that.
Just like
I like that.
So, Let's start with Joe time. Joe, when it comes down to it, does it matter if it's in black and white or color as far as your viewing preference of a movie that you feel you could connect to?
See, I'm different, man. I watch a movie for different reasons. I watch a movie for for the story itself, the acting, and if it's able to be portrayed accordingly with the film in itself, the color doesn't matter to me. If the timing of the movie, like I watched The Hustler just recently.
Right,
that was
right.
Black and white.
Yeah.
And then you got other movies like I got a couple of favorites. I mean, even like The Untouchables. I mean, The Untouchables then was black and white. Then they remade it and then in color, but probably not the same movie. So if we even talk about like Angels with Dirty Faces.
Correct.
Angels with Dirty Faces came out. It was in black and white, but then they remade it in color. And then that still the same movie, still the same great acting. And even like It's a Wonderful World. That was in black and white. And then they had it in color.
Yes.
Same exact movie.
Yeah.
Just in color. The storyline that has changed the movie itself, the feeling of it, is still there just because the way it's acted out and the way that it's played. I mean,
the storyline meant a lot.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
When you remember it, you don't even remember it in black and white or in color. You remember the feeling of how the movie was presented. Then you have movies like The Giver that are out now, like a modern day film. And then that's in black and white for the most part of the movie. Then it starts to transition into color.
That's right.
Ladies and gentlemen, Siskel and Ebert.
And then you have other movies like that movie Pleasantville.
That's right.
Pleasantville,
that's right.
Black and white, yeah. And then all of a sudden starts to break into color. So there's certain things that where the mixture of black and white and the color come into play, and it plays a big part of the whole movie.
Right, right.
Or there's ones where it's in black and white the whole movie, and then they remake it in color. There's certain movies like Cleo. Cleo is in black and white, and then if you watch it in color, it's powerful. It pops. There's a lot of purple in that movie. There's a lot of even some actors you wouldn't even know have blue eyes. Like Blue Eyes himself would be in a black and white movie.
I've got blue eyes.
And then you would see it and it would pop in color. So certain things like that. And then, but the movie that I would love to stay in black and white, Queens Boulevard.
Yeah.
Okay. That's cute. That's from Entourage. And then they colorized in the show. Yeah. It's a little Entourage inside joke. But yeah, honestly, for me, black and white films are always a go for me, and color go for me as long as the movie is good enough.
Now, you were saying that for some people, it might be a different type of experience in terms of viewing black and white.
Yeah. Well, and I grew up on black and white. My first TV was black and white growing up in the house.
Now you're fucking
weird. I swear to God. That's we only had black and white TV.
Really?
In the house, yeah. I didn't have cable until I was like 13, 12.
Okay.
I didn't have color television until I was like 10.
You know what, Gio? I can't tell if he's fucking joking or not because he's a comedian. I cannot fucking tell.
And he keeps a straight face. And he shows his dimples like, say something.
See, because today's generation... It's so fast, and everything is in color, smartphone, all this stuff. When you throw into the black and white element, it's almost like they're not interested. It's like, oh, that's just way
back. It's
almost
like you're moving back.
Yeah. And they don't want to view things in that way. But you're one of the rarities where you want to see everything encompassed in a way that's original and not tweaked. And that's a good thing.
Very good thing, I'd say.
Very good thing. Very good thing. Cindy, what do you think of black and whites, color films?
I think if a movie is made nowadays and it's made in black and white, it's done so for a reason.
Yeah.
Back then, obviously, that's all they had. So.
Limitations, yeah.
But now, if you like you mentioned Schindler's List, it was in black and white so that red jacket could travel through the movie.
That's right.
That's like the whole point. It's so symbolic, and it served a purpose to be in black and white. A movie that I can think of was one of my all-time favorite movies from when I was a kid and now is Some Like It Hot with Marilyn Monroe, Tony Curtis, and Jack Lemmon. They were going to shoot that movie in color, but the makeup was so harsh on the men's faces to get them to look like women that they shot it in black and white because it just looked ridiculous and hokey and horrible in color. Even though like much of that movie... probably would have been really stunning in color because it was filmed in Coronado.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's supposed to be Florida, but it was here, Southern California. But that's another one that I could think of. And I just think if something's made in black and white now, it's done so for a reason. And
ones were like the Twilight series. Not Twilight Zone. Twilight Zone, sorry.
A little different.
Twilight Zone, the originals.
Right.
Because even with that,
Rod Serling,
you wouldn't even need the color just based on the stories that was told.
Ron Jeremy.
Yeah, so it's like movies like that. And a lot of gangster flicks back then, keeping it dark just like that in black and white.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Even today, if we were to watch a modern day film on gangster film, I would love to see it in black and white, honestly. Okay. That'd be cool.
And that's really odd is like even on TV not too long ago there was a Walking Dead marathon in black and white.
Oh well,
yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's true.
So that it could have that old time horror feel to it,
Dawn of the Dead feel.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Which I thought was interesting as well. So you're right. It's not going to appeal to like masses. It's not going to appeal to the overstimulated, constant imagery crowd. But it is going to appeal to the smarter movie watcher, the person that's interested in the story, the person that's interested in the artwork.
Yeah, there you
she
go.
She called you smart.
She called. Yeah, she pointed at you, Joe.
Game recognized game.
That's right.
Lady Sage, where do you stand on all this?
I don't mind watching black and white movies if it's true to the time of the setting. Why not? Like for example, Captain America. If they did it in black and white, I would have still watched it.
Hmm.
I mean, wasn't that, Captain America back in the 1940s?
Correct.
Yeah,
correct. So that would have been amazing in black and white. Some Disney classic cartoons were black
Steamboat
and white.
Willie.
Right? And then they changed it to Technicolor, and it wasn't the same. So,
Betty
but then
Boop.
they're catering Betty it to Boop. The kids.
Right.
To the kids
she
that
had
will.
Some big eyes.
Yeah, there you go. Pardon. It's all good. So, yeah, that's my opinion.
Okay. Nice. Gio, what do you think about films being colorized from black and white?
They were big in my time. question again? Say it again. I told you that ADD is going to...
It's okay. It's okay. Black and white films. Do you, should they be restored or kept as is?
Hell, bring them back to life. Absolutely. We're in a new day and age, and we're very, very, very progressive. I'd say on a temporary standpoint, on a small part of the movie, if you need to go back, I think she had said it. If you need to go back for a specific reason, for a red jacket or per se, mm-hmm. I'd say go ahead and do it in black and white. But the entire movie, I think I would it would lose it for me. It's hard to move back, and I don't think we're used to that. I'm a big fan of the old days, but I think it's almost doing too much, and I think you're gonna lose the audience. And I think we're on a tight rope where the audience it's either you appeal to them or you don't, and mm-hmm. you're dealing with money. So I think you got to be a little bit smart on how you do it. So there you go.
So you think movies should be colorized that are black and white just for the sake of doing it?
I just say for the sake of for an appealing audience. I mean, I respect
Showtime.
There's you're a rare breed, and there's not too many people of you. I mean, I personally I like black and white movies if they're true to its day, and especially the original.
Yeah,
old movies, but I think newer movies, and they're done in black and white.
Depends on.
It's almost like I feel like it's doing too much. Just play that shit in color, and then if you have to go do a certain scene in black and white, go ahead and do it. But that's just me.
Yeah.
If you think about like Sin City, I didn't really like that the way it was filmed. It's just it was just the way it was filmed. That's all.
Yeah. Yeah. Storyline. The. Like camera that, views, everything.
Yeah, that was different.
Yeah.
I didn't really like that.
So why are we going to black and white when everyone wants 3D nowadays? So it's kind of going backwards.
It's hard to make 3D work well.
Yeah.
I think it has to be like big budget, you know, things like Avatar or Star Wars.
Yeah,
or
and that wasn't even really freaking 3D.
Things, you know, things that would be visually interesting in 3D.
Yeah. But overall, when it comes down to it, it just has to appeal. And I think certain movies, if they're going to be made for black and white, great. Make it effective. Good storyline. Move on. Certain movies should be just converted, I think, because certain movies, like I said, younger generations are going to tune that out. They want to see the color. They want to get that vividness. When they see something black and white, whatever. Like, as I pointed out, certain documentaries, certain speeches that are that leaders have spoken to the masses with, put that in color, I guarantee you the young generation is going to appeal to it and connect to it rather than seeing some kind of distorted black and white image of, say, Martin Luther King or Malcolm X or JFK. Put that in color and people will connect.
As I was saying earlier, you know, Disney did that with some of the cartoons.
Yeah.
Like the Snow White, and he mentioned Steamboat Willie. You know, some of the older classics, they refined it in a new Technicolor, and that made the kids watch it more like, oh my God, you mm-hmm. know, it's in color.
Yep.
So it's just a matter of, you know, finding that one company that will put time and effort, you know.
And colorization, everything.
Exactly.
There you go. So there you have it. Would you agree on that, Joe? Like certain, like good speeches are in black and white, colorize them. So our younger generation will say, hey, that's JFK. That guy's cool. Because they're connecting that to the full-color Obama stuff that we're
but
being presented
with. I even like how they came out with some if they make a JFK movie. I mean, I know they made the Kennedy movie, but not JFK. It was more of his brother.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, watching movies like that, that usually inspires me. When I was growing up, I mean, listening to, even watching, like, what was it, Ali?
Yeah.
When I grew
Will
up
Smith.
Watching it. So I didn't really know too much of Ali at that time.
Yeah.
But I knew, you know, things. But then watching that movie in itself really bring it to perspective, and you know, so
and again, that movie was in color.
Yeah.
See? Now if it was in black,
Raging Bull, which was black and
black
white.
And white,
black
yeah.
and white, yeah.
Robert De Niro.
Yep.
There you go. So there you have it. See, we have to have these very encompassing discussions because it's very thought provoking here on the Slam Show. That's for sure.
I was gonna make a joke. Why don't you just put that glasses like, you know, the they'll make everything in color.
There you go.
Oh, my goodness. All right. Our final topic, and I'm going to direct this to Giovanni. The new track from Kanye, Rihanna, Paul McCartney. Full 5 minutes before I wild on out. Is that how the lyrics go? Something like that?
I haven't even heard that song.
Yeah.
What song is this?
It's called 4 or 5 Seconds by Paul McCartney, Kanye, and Rihanna. And
who's
it's
Kanye? I never heard of
this.
Oh,
he'd be pissed.
Well, check this out. They performed it over on the Grammys and so forth. The video is out. And I wanted to discuss this because I wanted actually to break this down after the Grammys on the show following, but we didn't get a chance to. But the point was that Paul McCartney on the track is very underutilized because he's basically doing a guitar and a barely heard background vocal. You hear the featured stuff between Rihanna and Kanye, but not really any Paul McCartney. And I feel that that's a very big disservice to an icon like Paul McCartney because to me...
Sir. Paul McCartney.
So, yes,
yeah,
he is a sir.
He's a knight.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Been knighted.
Let's not forget the sir.
With the Excalibur sword. So, to me, you got to be able to present these icons in a way where they're featured, not just put in the background or used for name notoriety. For example, you had Aerosmith and Run DMC with Walk This Way. Aerosmith did the original. Run DMC collaborated with them and did the verses, but they're both featured equally. With this track, it's absolutely a waste of fucking time having Paul McCartney on there. And it's a marketing ploy. I get that. But if you're going to have an icon, put them out. Have them get a verse. Have them have a reprise on the song. Just don't have them, like, just adding on lip syncing in the video.
Like what Joe said, I've never heard of the song. Can we hear a sample of it? I mean,
sure.
Or just on our own?
No, I'll pull it
up. Okay.
But let's go ahead. Giovanni, what do you think about that? If someone said, okay, Giovanni, I want you to be on the track, and you said, yeah, no problem, but then you find out later on that you were barely even used in it, how would you feel about that?
I'd tell them to get that shit off the damn the radio and don't put me on there. It's that simple.
Really?
But it said it's already done.
You're still getting paid.
And you got paid $2 million
well, to someone
per
like
riff.
Just kidding. He throws his money up in the air. That's nothing to him. That's chump change. But, I mean, what can you do if it's already been recorded? Then, but here we go.
Here, let me jump into a little bit. See, that's Rihanna. Let me jump a little bit forward. And when you watch the video...
I see him. He's playing the guitar.
That's pretty... I like it.
The point is, you don't hear Paul McCartney on there.
He doesn't get a verse.
Yeah, he doesn't get a verse. He barely gets anything on the background vocals.
Not even a solo on the guitar?
Thank you. Thank you.
Is this a legal thing where they had to almost...
The mic. Closer to the mic.
Sorry about that. I was just asking, was he pretty much forced to go on there because of a...
That's a good question.
Legal... Was there something he created prior to where they said, okay, you guys can use this, tempo or melody because I created it, so you have to feature me? Because that's probably the case.
All right. There's a lot of intangibles that we may not know, but the point is, if you're going to put someone that's an icon on there, make them feature.
Well, maybe he agreed to his part of just playing the guitar and be the background and have the other two... sing it.
Right.
Yeah, he has to okay it somehow.
Right.
Yeah. But I want to hear Paul McCartney. Cindy, am I correct?
Yeah, I'd like to hear him too. I mean, it's not like he's not Carlos Santana.
Thank you.
I'm just going to hear him play the guitar.
Good point.
He plays
and
sings.
I love Carlos Santana.
Right?
Yeah, see, Carlos Santana plays.
Right.
He's known for that. He's not really known as a vocalist.
Right.
See? So, and...
I mean, Paul McCartney plays... piano, bass, guitar. There's so much he could do, and like any chump could have played that guitar part.
Something tells me he's okay with being that low. For some reason, I just think he's okay with that.
I'm pretty sure he is. Obviously, he's relevant, and it's funny because if you go on Twitter, you'll see all these youngsters like, oh man, whoever is this Paul McCartney guy is gonna come up.
They said that?
He's probably just laughing behind the scenes.
This Paul McCartney's really lucky to be on Kanye's track.
Yeah,
like,
he's gonna be famous now.
They said that?
I thought there's all these like screenshots of people's Twitter posts.
It's fucking embarrassing.
It is embarrassing. It's pretty sad.
It is sad. That's true, Joe.
That's hilarious.
It is. Oh my god, it's just like, oh, this Elvis guy is really gonna make it. Like, motherfucker, let me slap your ass, dude.
Oh, I mean, there were some girls when I was working in the junior section at Macy's, and they seen the Nirvana t-shirts, and they're like, oh, do you like Nirvana? Yeah, I like Nirvana. Oh, maybe we should try to go see them this summer.
Oh, wow. That's hilarious.
Like, oh my god, we need to go see them.
I just did one of those, like, forehead rub, like...
Younger generation needs to up their pedigree IQ with real music.
When Google is out there, they can't Google it first before they open their mouth.
That's
I mean,
what's so dumb is there's so much information.
They don't know how to Google.
Accessible.
You got a smartphone. I hate, don't you, I have to move on to a different subject real quick, but don't you hate when people, I hate this, when someone has a smartphone, they're like, hey, can you figure, like, asshole, you got a damn smartphone, blow it up on your damn phone. Anyways, go ahead, continue.
Yeah. It's true. I mean, everything is accessible, information is right there instantaneously.
But doesn't mean they're going to retain it.
That's right. I mean,
or take the 2 seconds to punch in, like, 5 letters and search for something, you know?
It's called being lazy.
It is very
enabling.
Lazy. Very lazy.
Yeah, so there might be something behind the scenes, like you were mentioning, Gio, where, yeah, you take my name, put it as one of the artists on there, even though I'm not technically doing much, and give me my cut. Right. Maybe it's a smart thing for Paul McCartney. It just showed the younger generation's idiot mindset because they had no clue who the hell Paul McCartney was.
I mean, he's got no one to prove at this point. He's like she said, he's a legend. So
he's a sir.
Somewhere right now, he's sitting there just laughing because he's like, these idiots.
He's like, I was bored. I needed a project for a bit.
Absolutely.
There you go. Is there anyone, Joe, that you'd like to have like come out of the woodwork and join up
the
with
closet?
Some? What was that, Gio?
Oh, I don't know. You were still coming out of the...
Yeah, someone that's like a legend and wants to go ahead and just jump on a Rihanna, Kanye track and just say,
you know,
hey.
Like, probably like Jimi Hendrix. A lot,
oh, yeah.
You know?
That's a lie. Not hologram.
He'd have to really come out of the woodwork.
Where's he playing at? I heard he's playing at
Concord Pavilion. We should go to his concert next week.
Oh, you said Concord Pavilion. That's even. Is it Sleep Train now?
No, they reverted back to Concord Pavilion.
Really? Yeah. Okay, yes, okay.
I think Sleep Train's up in...
Sleep Train?
Or no, it's down Mountain View.
No,
shoreline.
It's
shoreline.
No, Sack.
Sack. Gotcha.
It used to be Arco?
Yeah.
Arco Arena.
Okay. It's always going to be Arco.
These damn.
That's a handsome dude right there. Who's that?
Somebody to come back out.
That's alive right now. And doesn't it necessarily have to be like a comeback, but someone with real name recognition and...
Game recognized game.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
I don't even know what that means, but...
But it sounds good, doesn't it?
It does.
Man. Wait, like a big legend? Or like a Bay legend would be like...
Yeah, he only knows the Bay stuff.
Nah, I'm just
like,
kidding.
For example, I could Messy. Just think of someone like Barry Manilow.
I want Kenny Loggins.
I saw him.
I want Kenny Loggins to come back. What about that?
What, before he... That? Did you say before he died?
Yeah, he was with Earth, Wind & Fire. I saw Barry... No, wait, Barry, I'm sorry. I'm thinking of Barry White. Pardon me.
Okay. I was like, wait a second.
That's
Barry Manilow's
super different. Just a little
Barry,
bit.
Barry is the same name, right?
Man, you know that song Mandy? He sang Mandy?
Yeah.
Okay, that's Barry Manilow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Every Filipino likes Barry Manilow.
That's right.
Well, going back to what I said Kenny Loggins.
There you go. See? Someone that stands out.
Yeah, he's a songwriter too. He's not just an artist.
There you go. Come on, Joe, don't let me down. Give me a legend. Give me a legend here.
Man, you know, I don't really think
because
as far
Sage
back
already
as
threw
that,
something
like
that. All right, Cindy, give me a legend.
Willie Nelson.
Ooh.
Let Willie smoke.
I was thinking Willie Nelson, but I was gonna say it as a joke, but Tom really wants somebody.
That would be like, wow.
Neil Diamond.
Oh,
Neil Diamond, there you go. There you go. That's a crooner for you. All right, we're gonna go back to Joe. Gio, what's your choice? Legend that teams up with the major pop stars of today.
I was going to say Sinatra, but he's already done that. But I'd say
in the virtual world.
That's alive.
He's going to be alive.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know of anyone.
Michael Bublé?
No.
Kenny G?
Is this my question or your question?
No. Yeah, he'll just have his sax going through the whole damn thing.
Is he still playing?
Kenny G?
I'm sure.
Probably yeah. Cash Creek?
I'll do Ingeborg Humperdinck.
Ooh!
There you go.
That's real. Really? Come on, Joe, man. You got to catch up. Catch up.
I don't know, man. Actually, all the people I listen to all dead. From Al Green,
Aaron
dead.
Neville. I would say Aaron Neville would be really good.
Marvin Gaye, dead.
You know?
Who was that guy we ran into at CES?
About Wayne Newton?
At Nam? Like last year was his name? George
right there, George Clinton.
Yeah, George Clinton. Yeah.
George Clinton.
Didn't he just die too?
No. Dude, what's you and dying?
He's way alive, dude.
You have this connection with the death of artists here. He said Barry White. Oh, Barry Manilow. I said Barry Manilow. It's all good. It's all good.
Yeah. Okay, Joe passes again.
I said Wayne Newton.
Wayne Newton. Okay.
But I could care less. That's what I'm saying. Like, there's nobody I really want to really just
be elevated in that way.
Do a hook
at the moment. No, like,
yeah, Wayne Newton. He's what, Mr. Vegas still?
Yeah, but
I haven't seen him on a billboard in a while, right?
He's not Mr. Vegas anymore.
I don't think so.
I mean, we were just there and we didn't see him anywhere.
You're usually seeing a freaking billboard of Wayne Newton going into Vegas.
No. That's the men, was it Men from Down Thunder or Men from Under?
Thunder from Down Under. They're okay. An Excalibur, by the way.
So
Ed Harris.
Ed Harris.
You guys are too much.
And Harris.
Yeah, at Reno?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
March 15th.
That's funny.
There you go. There you go.
J.G. Wentworth. It's my money, and I want it now. Who knows that?
That
you just
is
saying some random shit.
We'll is that from Entourage?
That's one.
No, that's a commercial.
It's my money.
Daytime TV status right there.
Oh, my goodness. All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and take a quick music break. And this one's brand new by Jodeci, Every Moment. And if you listen to this, they go back to the 90s
Jodeci.
Style. Jodeci here on
we
the
We should bring them back.
Well, we're going to try. We had Mr. Dalvin on here, so why not again?
Next time we need to definitely hook him up with some liquor.
That's right. He was.
He was pissed.
Yeah.
He wanted to get his liquor on. That's.
He has more duels.
Exactly, and we'll have our exclusive interview segment with Giovanni Abanoha here on the Slam Show. Everyone, hang tight.
Yes.
Cars, clothes, girls, and games. Through the years, a lot of things changed. We shared a love like a melody. My sweetest moments. You.
anytime you want it. I'm lying here waiting for you.
Oh, yeah, that was brand new. Jodeci, every moment here on the Slam Show. And without further ado, we're going to go ahead and have our special guest in the house kick off the exclusive interview segment with a song. Ladies and gentlemen, Giovanni Ebanoha.
Woo! Woo! Oh, are we supposed to clap?
I'm over here on my camera.
The night is like a lovely tune. Beware my foolish heart. How white the ever constant moon. Take care my foolish heart. Oh, oh, there's a love between love and fascination. It's hard to see on that evening such as this, 'cause they both give very same sensation. Oh, when we're longing together for this one kiss. Oh, her lips are much too close to mine. Oh, beware my foolish heart. Oh, and should our eager lips combine, oh, then take care my foolish heart, 'cause there's a line between love and fascination, oh, and a dream that'll fade and fall apart, 'cause this time, baby, this time it's love, it's my fool. Heart.
Yeah! I wanted you to keep going!
That was dope.
He said tapos.
Wow. Wow, you have a gift there, Gio.
Thank you.
That is amazing. That is truly amazing. Let's have another big round of applause.
Thank you.
Is that your stage name also? Is your real name Giovanni?
That is dope. That is dope. So, let's get right into it. What made you want to sing that certain style?
I've always had sort of a love and connection with that style of crooning music. I guess since I was as early as I can remember.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what were your idols and people you listen to?
Well, I don't know. It's Sinatra, obviously, but back then it wasn't even didn't go that old. It was started off with Motown, you know, Smokey Robinson and the Stylistics, stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, and those sort of lowrider oldies.
Yeah, boy.
Absolutely, and sort of just progressed and it sort of stabilized as I got older to the more singer standards with the Sinatra style music. So that's kind of where I'm at. What I love.
Did it come really natural for you to sing that style, or did you have to refine it, and how that go about?
It's pretty much just all I know. It's just what I feel. It's just
I like how you're fucking answering these questions because it's so cool and like, man, yeah. I got it, Sam. Yeah. Uh-huh. But being you're such a young guy and mainstream music is everywhere, you never was compelled to say, hey, let me try that certain style?
Never, ever. On occasions, I'll hear something that's sort of soul-like with, like, even NSYNC.
Mm-hmm.
They'll come up with some good stuff. And
how about, like, Bruno Mars?
The guy's talented. I can't really touch his songs. But
Uptown Funk?
I was just watching that video. God, that guy's talented. Can't do that song, but...
Yeah, that's what Joe Time went in on is... intro for the comedy show.
That'll make anyone jump, even grandma jump.
Yeah, that was a good song.
Yeah, it's just good stuff. Jazz is awesome. It's It's awesome. Jazz is awesome.
So, I also heard you before sing in Filipino, a.k.a. Tagalog.
Is A.k.a. Tagalog.
Exactly. The whole dialect thing. Do you want to sing other styles as well, or do you want to focus on just the crooner, Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra stuff?
It's just primarily, I've pretty much found my niche, and that's definitely, I guess you would call it big band, with the big band behind you, with, you know, 32-piece instrumental musicians, orchestra behind you, and to me, there's just no better sound. And I forgot that group's name, but they even do modern songs, and it's like, good God, they sound amazing. You know, I shared it on my Facebook recently, but
Postmodern Jukebox.
It's something like that. Yes.
Okay.
It was like Bradley that. Something. God, I forgot his name. But he has these various artists that'll sing, and he arranges these new modern, even Rihanna songs, and
makes it into big band.
Into a big band jazz. Yeah. And these people that are you know, the new generation, like, God, jazz is actually pretty good.
Yeah.
So thanks to him, it sort of keeps what I want to do alive.
Oh, it's kind of like that Richard Cheese guy.
I was going to say, he's, yeah.
You guys both got the ping.
Yeah, I'm going to have to search that when we do our rounds with the other questions amongst the co-hosts. So, yeah, this is incredible because I've seen you sing, and I was truly impressed how,
like,
you're able.
In person?
In person.
Like where?
At a wedding that we both attended.
At a funeral.
Well, that's untrue, but but
I started as a funeral singer, believe it or not, in Pittsburgh. That's pretty much what I was known for.
Really?
Absolutely.
I'm not sure if you're fucking with us or what.
No, I swear to you. I mean,
like you sang the Ave Maria.
That's relevant.
Not like that, but it was mostly like, if any, you know, the whole Pittsburgh old Filipino, even Italian, the originals, if they always knew who to call. Can you sing my father's favorite song or whatever, and so I'd sing a
national okay.
Not a,
like
not
Bread
the
If.
Say again.
That song, Bread. If by Bread. Backwards. I like the song. I don't know.
I think it Go went ahead. Over his head.
He's singing not at the burial, but at the
rosary or the viewing.
The viewing, okay.
The ceremony, I guess you want to call it. Yeah.
Yeah, so you provide that vocalization. That's cool. Right on.
Now I know who to hire.
I retired from that.
Oh, okay. Now, who's dying?
Now, Gio,
more importantly. Yes.
Because you're so talented and so forth,
thank
obviously...
You,
Uptown Funk.
obviously, your talent's going to stand out. But have you had any naysayers or people that would look at you and just say, hey, youngster, this isn't for you, or they kind of doubted your ability? Have you ever encountered any of that?
Amazingly enough, no, I haven't. I've had amazing support, and I think it goes back to our conversation about an hour ago about, as long as you can just be who you are and have confidence in that, I think it kind of sort of solidifies exactly what you want to do, and no one can touch that.
Mm-hmm.
There's that saying, haters gonna be haters, right?
Haters cause they ain't us, bro.
Say it again.
Haters cause they ain't us.
Say it one more time now.
Haters cause they ain't us.
I want a round of applause for that. I like that.
It is like to despise us because they're
she's
not.
She's a cutie
us.
In the audience. Look at her right there. Yeah, she's cross-eyed too. But
oh, you're
just
a natural.
At both of us.
You're a natural there. All right, Gio, I'm going to have my air personality staff ask you a few questions. Let's go ahead and start it off. Mr. Time.
Yeah, man. That was an awesome song, by the way.
Thank you.
Have you ever serenaded a chick into, you know, either capturing her heart or dropping the panties, bro?
I would say a little bit of both.
There you go. Yeah, man. Any specific song that was the go-to?
Any specific colors that were thrown at you? any specific sizes?
Is it like a go-to song that you know would just get it, and you know you could just hit that?
No, but all of a sudden they know who Sinatra is. It's like, oh, okay, now you know.
What's your favorite Sinatra song then?
I've got a crush on you, sweetie pie. That's it. I've got a crush on you, sweetie pie. Yeah.
Keep going.
Keep going. Look at his
in
face.
A cunning cottage that we can sigh. I never pardon my much, cause I have got to crush my baby on you. Oh, yeah.
I don't have any panties, but.
You get your out or your boxers.
Oh, no. I'm actually not even wearing any right now.
Hot commando.
Well, what gets men's underwear thrown at you, right?
Yeah, right.
A shark.
Oh, no.
That's the only time. Yeah, about that.
Oh, my goodness.
Faison Love does a great bit on shark, man. Man, just the same. For all y'all don't know who Faison Love is, that's Big Worm. For fucking Friday. And I got to see him on Sunday. He's awesome.
Nice, nice.
But yeah, go ahead, man. That was awesome, man.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Sid.
All right. Let's see. Outside of Sinatra, do you have like a copy of the real book? Do you just what are some of your other favorites and what is
I mean, certainly Sinatra's just a go-to. He's more of the probably the only icon that this generation knows, so that's why I sort of revert to using his name. You know, I like all music. What was the question again? I think I missed
just some of your other favorites. What are some of your favorite songs to perform that, like, you really kill it on?
You know, I was doing a lot of big band and, like, you know, the jumpity stuff. And I really started to enjoy a lot of the really intimate with just a piano myself doing a lot of standards. There's so many out there. Where or When, stuff like that. The Ladies of Tramp can even be done in a really romantic, someday when I'm awfully low, that sort of thing. You know, Michael Bublé does that. And, that's.
You gonna come out with a Christmas album, bro?
That's a good question.
You know, it's funny when I play that in my car, not the Christmas stuff, but the big banner, that kind of music. People are like, is that Christmas? It sounds good. It's Christmas music. I'm like, it's just not Christmas music.
This is real music.
This is real music, yeah. So,
any oldies you like to sing? Not necessarily from that era, but from, you know, probably you were saying for the Stylistics era, probably Earth, Wind, and Fire, any of that.
I mean, I love them. Tower Power. I love,
Tower Power, yeah.
Always and forever, each moment with you is just like a dream to me that somehow came true.
Keep going.
And I know tomorrow will still be the same. 'Cause we've got a life of love that won't ever change. And every day, love me your own special way. Down on my heart away with a smile.
It makes me
want to
go like
There you go.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Oh,
man.
My goodness.
That's my time.
That's kind of cool, huh?
And I'm like, where's my lighter?
This guy is everything. You got applause.
I'm like, Sunday night oldies on the way home, man. Just.
You can't go wrong with that.
No.
Sage.
So, growing up, how were you inspired to be this crooner singer? I mean, what is a can you define that? Is it crooner or croony?
Croon. It's a croonish style in this time and age.
Wow, you sound like one of those Phil Am associate members.
I went in Pearl Harbor in 41. That's where I met your father.
Whoa, man, I'm
Mr.
getting flashbacks.
Maxim.
Whoa, you're revealing the last name there.
I didn't see it on the no two thing. What do you call it?
I think you forgot the question.
I need my pills.
Well, let me just
Well, yes, crooner is what they would call someone who does what I do. But I try to shy away from the whole. It seems to have that stigma of the whole Las Vegas.
Yeah.
What's that E word?
Erotica?
Lounge lizard.
Lounge lizard.
No, you know, when someone tries to I do not like impersonations, and I try to stay away, and I just try to, while Sinatra's a big influence, I don't wish to be an impersonator, but But yeah, how did I get? The question was, how did I?
Where's your influence growing up? Growing your up? Inspiration. I mean, were you like singing a lot of karaoke's at home?
Not necessarily. You know, my dad loved music, and I come from a pretty big family of music. Mm. My dad, my grandfather was in the famous 6th U.S. Army Band in Presidio. My dad played guitar, sat in with Malo, in fact. So I listened to a lot of old, you know, Malo and Santana,
mm-hmm.
and sort of just accumulation of different kind of music, and sort of found my niche later in life. Just kind of just melted into the whole, you know, Tony Bennett type of stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Have you?
And who's big right now? Tony Bennett and Lady Gaga. Gaga.
Did she get engaged?
Yes.
To Tony Bennett?
No. Wait, I have another question.
Something less complicated.
Are you a wedding singer? Because you would make a great wedding singer.
I've got about four planned coming up.
Oh,
yes.
Nice.
Yeah. Actually, for a DJ in Pittsburgh.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Looking for a DJ or for a DJ?
No, he's a DJ. He is a DJ in Pittsburgh.
It's his gig or his wedding?
It's his wedding. He just happens to be a DJ. Yeah.
Okay. So he's DJing his own wedding.
No.
I don't think he may after. Yeah, he may just do that.
He's
yeah.
just singing at the dude's wedding. And
yeah. But yeah. then he gave me this look like.
Is that a conflict of interest to say DJ about another DJ in front of another DJ?
No.
While talking to a DJ in the presence of other DJs. By the way, my name is DJ.
I had a question. So I like so
hey, DJ.
When you ask for DJ, when you were singing just earlier ago,
I was crooning. Excuse me. I'm just kidding.
Not necessarily the Frank Sinatra song, but you know the way you sang it was. In a sense, currently. So, would you be able to? I know you would be able to. Are you ever looking into like taking modern day songs and then?
Absolutely. I mean, I think that's the whole.
And then bringing them down
Richard
towards.
Cheese.
And this kind of this sort of melts into the same thing that we just discussed earlier with black and white movies. I mean, I think it's all about progression. I want to step beyond my boundaries and try to step on things that I can't even that I can't tackle. You know, just to fit in or gain a big. Fan group, but I'll definitely try to, you know, put myself out there and do some modern stuff, but keep my own style.
Well, yeah, use your style,
absolutely.
But that modern stuff, it'll be like a cover version, your
absolutely.
Style. It'll draw people towards you, and then you could actually put out what it is.
Oh, sure, absolutely.
And we'll you have some originals?
That was my next question.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, sorry.
You mean like stuff that
Joe,
I've written?
You've been asking all kinds of questions.
I'll pass. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah. You mean like stuff I've written or...
yeah, your own personal...
Have no more questions.
or things that somebody might have written for you to perform.
But it's original. It's not a cover.
At this point, I'm going to have to use the Fifth, the Fifth Amendment.
Plead the Fifth.
Pleads the Fifths. I'll plead the Fifths.
I think you should, you should be a comedian too because you're pretty funny. But maybe to just the Filipino audience.
Probably just the Filipino audience.
The next Rex Navarrete.
But for being a crooner, you would have to have that charisma, have that wit. Because that's what, all you know, Frank Sinatra had the wit in between time. And then he'd be doing his little shtick and all of a sudden kick right into his
There
gig.
You go.
Gotcha.
Put him under your wing, Joe. Yeah.
I guess I'm going to have to see you like in action. Like, you know, what would
you're... You're seeing me in action right now.
No, with your monkey suit. What is that called? Your tuxedo.
Yeah,
right?
See, I don't wear anything.
Oh, you don't?
He doesn't wear anything.
I don't wear...
yeah, he's going commando.
He's a thunder down under, dude.
We'll go see him for sure.
He just comes with a bow tie.
I'll talk to you afterwards, okay, sweetheart? No, I just dress up in a regular... modern tuxedo getup that anyone would wear at any type of normal function.
Okay, he said modern.
Speaking of function, I have a little video of you in action. Talk about this. Like, was this a performance or was it more like a practice run thing?
Well, this here, what you're watching is this is the Bay Area Big Band. The leader of this band, I have to give credit. He was the former composer for the NBC Orchestra,
nice.
And also he's worked with Frank Sinatra and Lionel Hampton. That's his band.
Mm-hmm. You're right there, front and center, right?
Yeah, this is our rehearsal. We're getting ready for a gig, probably about a few days ahead of that.
Mm-hmm.
So this is just me running over some charts.
Awesome.
Yeah.
See, that's kind of cool because obviously these rehearsals are going to end early, and you get to go home early, right?
Well, that there's from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m.
Okay. Well, that's probably the limit, right?
If they're union musicians, they cannot go a minute over. Otherwise, every single person has to be paid for that account.
Is that how it goes?
I can't talk on that behalf. That's too technical.
There's orchestral rehearsals where it's, you know, like a 100-piece orchestra, and the personnel manager has to jump out and literally stop in the middle of playing.
That's actually very, very true.
Wow.
Very true.
We're not paying a single dime.
No, it's very expensive. They have to pay overtime times all those musicians.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. If they're union. Yeah.
There you go. Do they need a turntablist? Because I will scratch and stop when needed.
Can you do that? Do you have one of those on your thing
like
there?
A car break?
I think you could do it. It doesn't have
You just
a...
did it with your mouth.
Yeah.
Actually, Joe's our human sound effects.
What?
He wants to do a reverse.
It's like, crap, now I can't do it.
Because I don't even know what it is. That's what he did.
Well, check it out. Speaking of covers where you would kind of put a spin, a big band spin, this is Richard Cheese doing Material Girl.
Some boys kiss me, some boys hug me, I think they're okay.
Wow.
If they don't give me proper credit, I just walk away. Cause we and I am a material girl. You know that we are.
He's a material girl.
I want to go for that song per se, but I mean, you know.
Now check this out. Check this out. This one's another Richard Cheese, but it's Insane in the Brain, Cypress Hill.
Sam.
Don't make me wreck shit. Hectic. Next, get the chair. Got me going like General Electric. And the lights are blinking. I'm thinking it's all over when I go out drinking.
So did you guys?
Oh, making my mind slow.
Remember Insane in the Membrane?
Yeah, I do.
That's it.
Bro, I got to maintain. Cause a nigga like me is gonna take. Insane in the membrane.
Wow.
Insane in the brain. Insane in the membrane.
I would have chose a different song for sure.
You guys know who, obviously you guys know who Seth MacFarlane is?
Yeah.
Yes.
You guys know he's an awesome singer?
Yes.
Guy's phenomenal.
Yeah.
I think he sounds, I mean, his voice sounds better than some people. I was going to say Sinatra, but no. No, he's got a really, really nice voice. Yeah. He's just very, it's almost too perfect.
His voice box is like the way he's able to manipulate it.
That's the thing. He's so perfect at it. He can just,
His manipulation.
So commercial. I mean, it's, absolutely.
It's awesome.
Just like you, Joe.
Just like you.
That nice commercial style of satisfaction of everything here.
That's too much.
Satisfaction.
That's too much. You want to sing a real quick verse in Filipino?
Really?
Yeah.
Of what?
Just any
Some
track.
Sharon Canetta.
Just real quick.
I don't know any
the
songs.
Just
a
verse. The Filipino side of Joe's coming out.
Dahil sa'yo nais kong mabuhay. Dahil sa'yo hanggang mamatay. Dapat mong tantuin. Wala nang ibang giliw, puso ko'y tanungin ikaw at ikaw rin. Dahil sa'yo, ako'y lumigaya. Pagmamahal ay alayan ka kung tunay man ako, ay alipinin mo ang lahat. Sa buhay ko dahil sa'yo.
Wow. What do you think of that, Lady Sage? Because she sings that on karaoke, but she has to read it. She doesn't recite it.
She has to read it.
Don't put me on blast.
Hey, but hey, you guys could maybe do a duet later.
That's an idea. I just felt the lightning? Oh, the lightning
bolt.
The lightning. The lightning Thor.
The lightning striking you?
Lightning strike.
Bad idea.
We have Matt in the chat room. He said old school Pinoy style. So he's giving you props.
Hey, thank you very much. Maraming na maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikinig.
What did you just say for Cindy?
Your hair is blonde with nice highlights, and you're
not even blonde.
What is that?
I don't know.
You didn't understand that?
Thank you, everyone. What did I say? Thank you, everyone. That's all I just said.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Thank you, everyone, for tuning in and listening.
Yes.
There you go.
I
heard Salama. That's all I got.
Yeah, mm-hmm. There you go. That's all you need. That's thank you. So,
yes, it is.
So, Gio, we're going to go ahead and take a quick music break and be back with the vaunted Q&A. 10 questions we're going to ask you.
I thought you guys just asked me that.
Oh, we got more. We got way more.
We're going to ask you a rated X.
Well, hey, that's what Sage says. We'll see. Just a little Lena Rowe for you. We'll be right back. That's our fellow co-host, Lena Rowe. Do the same. I'm feeling this track. I really am.
Yeah, like especially it. The beginning. She says she's jumping in the shower. Did you hear that part?
Yeah.
So
jumping in the shower.
That's kind of hazardous.
Too hazard.
You got to have that.
Slip.
The non-slip.
Non-slip.
Non-stick.
Non-stick. All of it. All right, guys. Oh, you know what that means.
Death March. The Sith Lord Vader.
Please welcome.
It is the vaunted Q&A. 10 questions we're going to ask our special guest, Giovanni Abanoha. Is he ready for him?
Mm-hmm.
We shall see. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, I'll go ahead and kick it off. Number one, what's your favorite song right now?
Oh my God.
Don't say NSYNC.
Don't say Sinatra either.
He's not a song.
Don't say your favorite song at all.
I don't know how to answer that. You guys may...
gave so much red tape.
No kidding.
Richard Cheese. Anything from Richard Cheese. The Brady Bunch theme.
Hey. Calm it down over there. Hold on.
That is a true Filipino.
You know, I like... I like big butts and I cannot lie. That one that you just mentioned by Bruno Mars. I really like that
Uptown
song.
Uptown Funk.
Yeah, absolutely.
Same I with like Joe. That. He loves that fucking song.
It's a good song.
Makes you really want to.
That song keeps coming up on video 3:00 in the morning on, what was it?
Yeah.
Revolt?
Because we're up that late.
Who's up at? I'm not going to ask.
Yeah.
Bastosin.
Bastos.
Bastos.
Bastos into that music.
Wow.
Uptown.
I can see that.
That's too much. Take it away, Joe.
Your favorite place to eat.
Don't say BJ's.
As I'm looking at him, no. Goldilocks, dude.
What?
No, I actually like there's a Chinese restaurant in Orinda. Can I name drop or?
Absolutely.
It's been my favorite place for a long time. Yan's. They used to be in Lafayette, and then they moved to Orinda.
Okay.
My favorite Chinese restaurant in the whole world.
Sounds like a slam show field trip.
Oh,
Where in Orinda? Near the theater?
Do you know how small Orinda is?
Yeah, no, I'm saying, like, is it near the theater?
Actually,
in the same vicinity?
Sakabila, on the other side. On the other side, it's like when you exit, coming from down yonder.
Down yonder.
Down this, from this
down
way.
Down under, thunder down under.
Again, sexual remarks. Jesus. Yeah, pretty much. It's just coming from this.
And it's called Yang's.
What are we talking Yang's. About again?
Yang's.
Your favorite Chinese.
Like
Yeah. No, sweetheart. No. No, it's Yang's, just like Yang Can Cook, and it's phenomenal food.
Okay.
Pot stickers, crispy duck, lemon chicken. Field trip.
Absolutely.
Yeah, look, called field trip. Like, we don't eat Chinese food like every day.
Panda Express is not Chinese food.
Ooh, check.
He called me.
But
on
you guys know it was checking into Taosin Jin.
That place is actually pretty good.
I see that on your Facebook. All
they check
right
in somewhere else, but they eat at Panda Express.
That's the secret.
Like, hey, people at this table, can I take a picture? Pretend it's
for
mine?
Publicity reasons.
Yeah, for real.
Number three, your favorite store to shop.
I like Nordy's a lot, Nordstrom's in Walnut Creek.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, I'm maintenance. Yeah.
I can barely step in there without feeling like I feel like Julia Roberts is fucking
wearing your Lacoste and whatever True Religion jeans over there, I guess.
These are Levi's.
Get it right.
No.
So he shops at Nordstrom's Rack.
Actually no. I mean I like Nordstrom, but Walmart? I don't know. I feel like I have to downgrade just to justify,
All right, Nordy's it is.
Nordy's.
You know, you can find a lot of sales over there.
What movies can you watch over and over again? I know you don't watch television, but we're talking movies.
White Chicks.
Okay.
Really?
Absolutely.
What is your why?
It's funny.
Well, that's true. It's pretty funny.
Is it not funny?
It's pretty funny.
The comedy on it is just funny.
I was reading something that the Wayans are going to do a part two of it.
Yeah,
they're just trying to like lose so they could still look feminine. Mm. Yeah, so.
It's more Sean than it is Marlon, I bet.
I bet. Good old Wayans.
That whole movie is just I can laugh just even thinking of
it. It actually really is funny. It was well written.
I think the best part when he was like, the betrayal, and then it's like,
Terry.
It was something like, you mean to tell me all this whole time
you're not white?
You're not white? Oh my god, that was funny.
It's an all white party.
And Terry Crews was funny as hell too.
Yeah.
Didn't he just?
No, he didn't die. Oh my god.
I keep talking about death. She keeps talking about sex.
Am I mic's going limp?
It's getting flaccid.
Oh my goodness.
Lake flaccid.
Number five, give me one superpower you wish you had. Should I say it in Tagalog?
What kind of questions are these?
These are safe ones. You wanted to
make
it safe.
Yeah, you are rated G.
I'm getting dizzy off these questions. What's the question again?
Give me one superpower you wish you had.
I wish I could
fly.
Fly me to the moon. Ooh. No,
maybe
actually no.
Stars.
Yeah. How did you know that? You guys are Frank, distracting me. I told you don't do that to me while I'm on these questions. Okay.
Let him focus.
No. I wish I could go back in time. I guess.
Nice. Oh, time traveler. Okay. We haven't heard that one on.
Yeah.
That's a new one.
Why? You gotta ask why.
I have to visit my roots. Absolutely.
Okay.
See where I came from.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Find out those singing DNA genes.
Yeah.
That you're wearing.
Yes. Certainly. Certainly.
All right.
All right. Perfect. Favorite class in school?
I didn't go to class. You know, I've always loved art. I was always such a, you can always express yourself and just do whatever you wanted. I'd say art. Art was good.
Yeah, art it is.
And a shout out to a teacher that was in the art class.
Yeah. Her name is Mrs. Roll, but I believe she's Mrs. Evans now, I think. I just ran into her a few weeks ago in, in Lafayette.
Wow.
And you guys had some Chinese food.
No, we didn't. If you're listening, Mrs. Roll, I would love to take you out on some Chinese food.
And there
sing,
you go.
And a sing of some Sinatra.
Whoa, pick up.
Sorry, Miss Evans.
There you go.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, my goodness. We should call that 1 point shade of gray.
Yeah.
1 point shade of gray.
Working on two. Can we get a three? Next question.
Number seven. What's the weirdest phobia you have?
Oh, that's
singing so, in front of people.
No, I don't know. I don't know the name of it, but it's when there's like, I saw it on the internet. It was like clusters of holes.
Oh yeah.
You saw that shit?
Yeah.
That shit freaked me out for like a month.
What? What? How? What?
No, it's just like.
I saw a titty, with holes in it.
It's with
like with stuff inside, like little stuff inside, and it made me cringe.
That's a Photoshop of a plant.
You know it is. It's called
it's a plant.
But it's an actual phobia, right?
Yeah,
it is an actual phobia. Yeah.
Okay,
of
so
holes?
Of like tiny holes, clusters of it.
Yes.
I'll pull that up for you. I'll see if I can find it.
Oh my gosh.
Not for you, just for Sam. I don't look at it.
I don't get the concept of holes.
That's why you're a girl and we're guys.
Yeah. But wait, I'm saying that I'm afraid of them. So what does that say? No, I said I'm afraid of hoes. You didn't listen.
Cindy, text me that picture, please.
I will do that.
Your celebrity crush.
Oh my god, Justin Bieber. No, I'm just kidding.
Speaking of Photoshop,
Sam. Yeah,
Sam,
you guys
Sam.
Saw that.
Man, you kept staring at him.
I feel honored.
Well, he's staring at me.
Guapo.
Ganda yun eh. Gandang lips naman yun.
Ooh.
Ang complexion niya, naku palang Diyos.
I know Joe gets that one. He's putting that together. He's pretty intelligent when putting together Filipino words, even at those bits and pieces.
Yeah. Celebrity crush. And if I say Sinatra, you're going to kick my ass.
Right? I will.
No. You know.
Guy and girl.
Yeah, I can give you both. God damn. These questions.
No wonder you didn't go to class.
I'd be bad on Family Feud. Ikaw ang aking puso, sabihin mo sa aking puso, nabibinyang kita.
Oh my god.
Not Mariah. I like Beyonce.
Okay.
And...
Jay-Z. Get the couple. Sleep with the couple.
I don't know. Zac Efron is a hottie. No, I know. He's a good actor. I like Zac Efron. And like Beyonce, she's a good... I like her voice. She's very talented.
Not her butt. Her eyes. Her knees.
Head, knees, and shoulders.
The back.
And
I really like the back of her knees.
Yeah, I like her talent. Can we just focus that I'm trying to be really genuine here?
Fair enough.
This is supposed to be very conservative.
President's Day. Favorite president, that should be one of the questions.
Oh, actually, I do have a favorite president.
Okay.
All right.
Clinton.
Speaking of Lewinsky, this whole show is like blending in so well.
It is. It's full of
Who's
mixtures.
Your favorite president?
I like Reagan.
Okay.
So you're a...
Don't say it.
Okay.
I don't...
Don't say
I can't it. Speak about politics.
Okay.
When I'm in uniform. I'm serious. But I'm not in uniform.
I know, I'm like, you're not.
I'm not really wearing too much right now.
Oh, here we go.
Any specific reason why Reagan?
guy's a fucking handsome stud. And he was born the same year as my grandpa. And he was friends with Fernan Marcos. Yeah, he was. Yeah. You know who Fernan Marcos was?
I do not.
He's an ex-president of the Philippines.
Yeah, he did.
Like Joseph Estrada?
No, he was an asshole. Joseph Estrada. He was a clown.
Yeah, my grandpa used to call me Joseph Estrada.
I mean, he was a good-looking dude. I mean, he was a big playboy.
He was a womanizer.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Are you a womanizer? Womanizer ka ba?
I don't believe so.
I don't believe so.
Parang swabi na swabi mo eh.
Oh, shit.
Hey, the question's for you, sir.
Evidently, this night's all about you tonight for some reason.
Yeah, right.
Who's the guest here? I can't.
So the celebrity kush is me.
Ronald Reagan.
Went to Ronald Reagan. Well, favorite president.
If I'm
going to
be on
crush.
The show again, I'll definitely say you. Yeah, you're always a crush, but yeah, Ray. Wait, was it Reagan?
It was Beyonce and Efron, and then the favorite president is
Reagan.
Yeah, so we're listening.
Yeah.
We're listening. We're paying attention. All right.
Next question.
Number 9. Do you believe in ghosts, UFOs, or both? And if you have any experiences?
Mm-mm. You know, the Philippines. Mm-mm. I don't believe in that.
Really?
No, not really.
Really? You seem like one that would. Within your travels and so forth.
I had one experience, and I don't even deem that to be any reason for me to believe in ghosts. But,
really?
No,
it seemed like
really.
It was kind of...
No, my cousin, Eric, is very scared of ghosts. So
really?
Yes, absolutely.
Now we know what to do with him. When he gets on the show in June, scared the fuck out of him.
He's very scared of ghosts.
Have someone dress up in some white sheets.
His big. Well, I was saying his big gun. His big muscles can't protect him from ghosts. Cause
big muscles.
They're already dead.
They're already dead.
My big bazooka. My big anaconda.
Oh, he said it.
Oh, my God.
He said it.
Gusto mo manakita?
No, thank you.
Eh, pag na hindi siya nakatinga, kung mag-ano, andito na. Sige.
I don't know what he's saying. Tara.
Yung kamay mo.
He said, like, when he's not around, I'll show it to you. I know. Yeah. I understand.
Shh, you guys, put it on mute. Put it on mute.
Oh, my goodness. Close it out, Joe.
Do you have any hidden talents?
Like physically? Can I utot real quick?
Utot.
What's that, Joe?
Fart.
Ooh!
That'll be the give best exiting exiting strategy. Hidden talents? I can cook pretty damn well,
ooh,
I'd say.
Okay.
Filipino food.
Really?
Yeah, which most people don't.
Top two.
Yeah.
Kilauin, which is like a ceviche goat.
Yeah, that's isn't that a Chamorro dish? From Guam?
That's Kilauin, but it's very similar to the Ilocano dish.
Mm-hmm.
Who said, that sounded like a... Is that you?
Yeah, yeah.
Who said, mm-hmm. I almost said the B word.
It's okay.
Adobo?
Yeah, absolutely.
Chicken or pork?
I like pork.
You got any sugar in there? No.
That's a secret.
Brown sugar. Brown sugar.
Brown sugar. And you can actually use that Japanese vinegar.
Japanese
it's going
vinegar.
Limp again. Sam, she's used to that.
Oh! I'll let you get away with that one.
Well, no comment.
Her audio, I'm saying the audio equipment, I keep seeing it fall down.
Yeah.
So your hidden talent is you're a great chef.
Yes, absolutely.
Awesome.
And
there
I would love to cook for you next time.
And I was getting to that. You need to bring us some food next time. We love to eat here.
Sorry,
on the Slam
Show. Sorry, Mrs. Rao, was her name?
Mrs. Roll.
Mrs. Roll.
Mrs. Evans.
Yes, hyphen Evans.
Hyphen Evans.
Oh, my goodness. Well, Jill, congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
You survived a haunted Q&A.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, I have a few more questions before
sure.
we close out the program. What's your goals with the singing effort? What do you see yourself in, like, a year, 2 years?
Every year, every few months is always certainly a surprise for me, and it surprises me. So I certainly have the highest goals, and I see myself being more acquainted with a little bit more more significant artists,
mm-hmm.
and hopefully making an actual recording.
Yeah.
And recording with more renowned orchestras and performing probably, you know, in more larger venues like places like San Francisco and big symphony halls and stuff like that.
Nice.
So that's awesome.
I would love that.
Are you signed with an agent right now?
Currently not.
Okay.
Not. I'm
now
something I'm looking into. I'm looking into it.
Well, hopefully you do, because that's going to lead up to getting more gigs, and who knows? This might be a full-time thing for you.
Hopefully so.
And you will no longer be delivering.
To who?
You said not to mention his name, right, guys?
I didn't know about this.
Oh, well,
because you were, doing something. Yeah.
Oop, oop.
Let's just say he's a very significant athlete in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I emphasize San Francisco.
Okay.
Emphasize.
Emphasito.
Yeah.
Secret.
I am the personal mailman of.
Yeah.
It's coming up.
Yeah. A very prominent
athlete.
I won't say what city. Did I say what city?
He just said San Francisco.
I think we should just stop him there.
Yeah. Or let it be.
It just stop it there.
Whatever you want to say.
But yeah, so.
My top agency. Athletes are Buster Posey. Will Clark.
See what we do on the Slam Show? We just make shit happen. When the guests
it
don't.
It sort of just happens, actually.
We just put them on hypnotize mode.
Absolutely.
That's for sure. Well, Giovanni, what are some social media names and handles that people could follow you at? Facebook and all that
stuff. I actually have a website, www.singingmailman.com. From there, you can see different links, like my Facebook, which is facebook.com. I believe it's /Giovanni dot Abinoha.
Mm-hmm.
And...
Or they could just Google you.
You can Google me, and you can find your way.
I don't think there's too many Giovanni Abinohas everywhere.
Are you on Instagram?
I am, and I think my name is Giovanni on there. I don't know how to do that. I'm so new to this.
It's okay.
Just Google Giovanni.
Bagosa, I know. Yeah, just Google my name, and you'll find it. Google will find you everything. It'll find you love. It'll find you happiness.
Oh my goodness!
I had fun tonight.
All right. Fun tonight. I'm glad. So, because of time constraints, we're gonna go ahead and do our shouts and plugs. So, Joe, time, take it away.
DJ Slam and Sam, thank you, man, as always, conducting this awesome Slam Show train. My man Gio, bro. Every time you speak in that Tagalog accent or Filipino accent, I always like jump flashback to like when I was a kid at my grandma's house, bro. Like every time, I'm like, oh shit, it's like weird. So time traveling is something you can happen. But yeah, appreciate you being on the show, man. You have an amazing talent. Keep refining those chops, bro, that you got, and present it to the world. I mean, you got 5,000 people plus, and keep it going, keep it growing, and I can't wait to see you doing the Symphony Hall in San Francisco, and then some, probably even Madison Square Garden, dare to, take it to the next level, and keep on keeping on.
Thank you.
But yeah, I appreciate your spirit, your charisma, and just the energy you bring, man. Miss Lady Sage, I appreciate the honorary ribbon.
Yes, thank you.
Got that from
Noel Coughlin's Rare.
Yeah.
Runforrare.org.
Runforrare. And yeah, I'm glad you had a great weekend with Sam being your,
being my chauffeur.
Being your chauffeur.
And I ended up being the chauffeur.
Failed at chauffeur.
Yeah, for real.
That guy.
And
he's been staring at me the whole time.
I'm glad you had a great time out in Reno doing your thing. And I always get to see
the biggest little city in the world.
It was cool being able to go pick up, being the food caterer today.
Yes.
Not the caterer, but picking up the food.
The picker-upper.
The picker-upper. And Mike Ill, wherever you at, man. I hope you're doing well. Shout out to all my people that came out to support past weekend. If anybody else wants to come out and support, next Joe Time Comedy Show is March 24th, Tommy T's, Pleasanton, 7:30. Just say the Slam Show and you guys are in there for free.
Yee.
Say Joe Time, you're in there for free.
Yee.
Say, hey, I'm here to see the show for free. And you'll get it for free.
One more time.
Free.
Oh, I love it.
And man, and shout out to my sponsors, Lana's Egg Whites and Heinz Realty. Appreciate you guys. and then everybody that's just been supporting me. And if I missed anybody, next show.
That's right.
You can follow me on Instagram, Joe_time, and / on Facebook, Joe Time Comedy.
There you go. Captain.
All right. Thank you, crew. Thank you, Giovanni. Hope to see you perform sometime soon. So kind of keep us in the loop of your performance calendar. I'd like to check that out. I can be found on Twitter at RowdyRez69. And
Instagram
is _Captain_ _fantastic_. There you go.
You like that lip sync? Dead on. Cool.
And that's it. That's all I got.
Well, first and foremost, I want to thank our guests. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to be with us. And, of course, the Slam and Sam. Joe Time, sorry I missed your performance this past Friday, but I will see you next time if my schedule permits. Captain Fantastic, nice to see you again, and hope we could work out together at UFC again. That was fun.
That was fun.
That was really fun. We really kicked ass.
Yes,
we
did.
And, of course, to all of our sponsors, starting with Little Jace, thank you for the sandwiches. Strike First Nutrition, Natural Life Foods, Alex, what's up? And anyone that I missed, just go to the website, www.tvepn.com, and I could be found on Instagram at LadySage97.
No underscores.
No underscores.
That's simple enough. Giovanni, take it away.
Sam, first and foremost, thank you so very much. Sam, the cross-sided girl in the audience, and to all you other 5,000 fans out there. Joe, my man.
Buddy.
And to the very conservative lady in the background there with the blonde hair I said earlier with the highlights. Awesome.
And you call her Vanessa.
Not Vanessa with the singing career.
That's
the X-rated
Vanessa.
Video queen. You know what I mean?
Oh,
and of course, she's wearing Uggs. I like that. No, that's...
It's sexy?
And you know it. Clap your hands.
It's
Lady
warm.
Sage, thank you so much for everything that you've done.
I did? What I do?
It's what you're going to do. But
I actually met you before at some birthday.
WPLJs.
Yeah, but we were so
drunk.
Intoxicated that we weren't really formally introduced, so
well,
it was nice meeting you.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Again.
This was a wonderful experience, and I appreciate you giving me the opportunity to share my love for music, and especially to kind of...
talk about it.
Talk about it, especially this specific type of music, jazz.
Yeah.
That's what I love, and thank you. And
you're welcome.
I hope to be here again.
Yes. We'd love to have him back, guys, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
He'll make an awesome co-host because he has some...
Take it away.
He's pretty funny over here with his accents.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, darling.
All right, I'll go ahead and close out the shouts and plugs. I'd like to thank my entire crew, Sage, Cindy, Joe, for doing a tremendous job as always. Giovanni Ebonoha, thank you, sir, for coming out hanging with us. And we will definitely get you back on so you could croon us again.
Croon us.
Yes. Yes. Oh, you got a nice grip there.
So sweaty, dude.
Why are you clammy, Slam?
Hey, he's making me clammy.
Oh, no.
Oh, snaps. All right, I'd like to thank everyone that's in the chat room interacting throughout the program. And I believe Eric Ebonoha is in there, so shouts out, Eric, for hanging out. I think he came in like at the last 15 minutes, but hey, you tried. And everyone that's tuning in anonymously, thank you for all your support. Be sure
thank
to like
you.
Our Facebook page at TVEPN, The Slam Show, and catch me over at Farrington's Bar in Pleasant Hill this Saturday.
Next to Nations.
We'll In-N-Out.
Nations.
Nations.
I thought you guys said In-N-Out earlier.
Nations.
His stomach said In-N-Out.
Exactly. All right, guys, for myself and everyone here on The Slam Show.
Mabuhay.
We'll see you next week. Peace.
Salamat.
Another Richard Cheese special.
Nice. They told him, don't you
ever come around here. Don't wanna see your face, you better disappear. The fire's in their eyes and their words are really clear. So beat it, just beat it.